Parents no longer being able to afford the fees. Jane Solomons reports.
St Audries School on the West Somerset coast near Willerton was founded 85 years ago. Pupils and teachers are now away on half term, coming to terms with the news governors found so hard to break.
A terrible time, and a job I would never want to have to do again.
What do you think is the main reason for the financial crisis?
I think basically many parents are finding it difficult to meet the fees because a lot of them have to meet them out of income, and that is the most expensive way of paying school fees. And I think that the increasing pressure on parents from a variety of things with mortgages and so on have all added up.
The news follows financial problems at St Brandon's School in Clevedon, where pupil numbers have dropped by a third in 5 years. A last-ditch attempt to save the school will be announced tomorrow. St Gilda's Convent at Langport will close in July. There are no longer enough nuns to teach, and the building's too expensive to run. Many St Audries pupils come from farming families hit by the recession. Parents in the Forces have had education grants cut. Many parents can no longer pay fees of £4,000 and £7,000 for boarders. Governors say the school's been running at a loss for 4 years. Pupil numbers have dwindled from 250 to 174. But when 10 left in 1 week last term, running costs could no longer be met. And these desks will remain empty after July. 14-year-old Pamela Knox and her friend Minette Sloot are well into their GCSE studies at St Audries.
Wow, that's a great shock. I really had no idea about any of this, and I just went white and I was shaking.
What will you do for your studies now?
Well, we're just looking at many possibilities. It's going to be very difficult because all the schools do different examining boards.
Minette, I gather your mum and dad are abroad. Yes. What did they say when they got the news?
Well, they were also very shocked because they had no idea that anything like this would happen.
The Church of England's Education Society owns the building. It'll now be sold.
It will close at the end of the summer term, and it's blaming the recession. The independent girls' school has seen pupil numbers drop from 250 to 170 over the last few years. Now the governors say it's no longer a viable business, as Clinton Rogers now reports.
For more than 80 years, St Audries School has been turning young girls into young ladies. It is one of the most prestigious independent schools in Somerset, with fees of up to £7,000 a year. But now St Audries has fallen victim to the recession. Pupil numbers have fallen dramatically, and for the last 3 years the school has run at a loss. Now the governors have announced it will close at the end of the summer term.
The underlying reason is economic. The fact that we don't have enough girls to support the school financially, and that parents are finding it increasingly difficult to be able to pay the fees, particularly for boarders. We've had a lot of children withdraw because the father's businesses have collapsed.
The pupils of St Audries were on half-term holiday today. Over the next few weeks they'll be found places at other independent schools in Somerset.
Fortunately, most schools have vacancies so that they can take the girls. For the staff, that's much more difficult. Obviously, I shall have to try and help the staff as well to get new jobs. It's extremely sad because this is a very happy school and we turn out very competent, confident girls who academically can stand with anybody.
No one is yet sure what will happen to the buildings, which are owned by the National Society for the Promotion of Education in the Church of England. St Audries is the third independent school in the West Country to announce serious financial problems. The others are St Brandon's in Clevedon and St Gilda's Convent School in Langport. They all blame the recession. This is Clinton Rogers for BBC West in Somerset.